What's up, nerdlings?
What up, nerdlings?
Are you ready to nerd all about it?
Yeah.
Hey, nerdlings. It's your girl, JLove81, and you're watching Do You Nerd?
Well, another fun community topic has been making the rounds. Your first video game console. Memories, stories, anything about it. Let's just talk about that first video game console. And you and I, on this one, are on the same page.
We are.
There's no school like the old school.
Wood grain, that is.
The Atari 2600. Both of us have memories of this being the first home video game console in our home.
That's because we're old.
Yeah, we are. Right here, I've got the 6 switcher. We have packed away somewhere the 4 switcher and the Vader. I know that the one that I had growing up had the wood grain. I don't remember which switches
and
it had.
And that's the way I am. I do not remember whether we had the 4 switch or the 6 switch, but that wood grain.
First and foremost, honestly, I don't even know how it came into our home. Being a kid that young, one day it was just there and games. It just happened. That's to say, it wasn't like a birthday present, it wasn't a Christmas present or anything like that. I don't think there was anything tied to it. No holiday, no gift exchange. It was just, I think my dad wanted to try this thing out, and so he got us one.
I think it's the same for me. I think it was, if anything, my dad was the salesman, probably talked him into the coolest, newest thing ever, and it was there.
I was fascinated as a kid by the fact that you could change out the games. Bearing in mind, I didn't really know any difference. It's not like we had an old Pong machine or anything, but it was still so cool to have these old cartridges, or as my family called them growing up, tapes, video game tapes, later became Nintendo tapes. But you had those tapes and you could change out. The games that really come to my mind, there are 3. First, combat. I'm pretty sure everybody had combat. Me and my stepbrother, we must have put hours upon hours into that game. Tanks, planes. I think there was an invisible mode and we would just play them all, cycle through all of them endlessly.
Tactics.
I can't remember what I was saying.
Second, Pac-Man. Where I grew up, there really weren't any arcades around, so the Pac-Man that came out on the Atari, that's the Pac-Man I knew for the longest time. Even the sounds are still ingrained into my brain.
So for you, you didn't know any better that the Pac-Man on the arcade was better than the Atari Pac-Man.
Oh, exactly.
So to you, there was only one Pac-Man.
Yeah, there really was. So, and I was perfectly fine with it.
I was going to say, in a way, that was kind of a benefit for you.
Yeah, because then when I went to the arcade and tried the actual Pac-Man, well, that was just an upgrade to me. And the last game was Carnival. The only reason that game sticks out to me is because that was one that my dad would play all the time. My dad really didn't play a whole lot of video games. I don't know what it was about that game, but he was obsessed with it. And it's just like a shooting gallery game at the carnival. But he loved that game. All right, I'll stop going on and on. What about you? You got a story for the old 2600 here?
Well, for me, the games that I remember the most was Kaboom. The biggest memory that I have from Kaboom is just, I really enjoyed the paddle and turning that knob. That was a novelty to me, and just making it go as fast as I could. Just spinning it across the screen as fast as I could.
Kaboom is a great game to try that with because you get going so fast. And honestly, the paddle controller is so responsive.
Yeah, yeah.
When you think about the tech at the time, it's incredible how responsive they still are.
The funny thing is I always remember that game, but I could never remember the name of it. Like, half the time I'm always asking you, what's that game where you got the thing at the top and it drops bombs and you go back and forth and you always remember the name?
With the Hamburglar?
Yeah, that's what I told him too. I said, I remember. I thought it was the Hamburglar at the top. And that's how I could always remember the game and describe it to people.
Rubble, rubble.
But I guess he's just a burglar.
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 Purple. Bunkular.
To be fair, when you have such a generic name like Kaboom, it's easy to forget exactly what that game was called. Frogger, on the other hand, it's kind of a different terminology, but Frogger has gone on since then. It's still around today, and you kind of have a little mini collection of Frogger.
I do. Have, you know, like I have a little figurine of him. I have a board game of him. I have one of those tabletop arcades from it. If I see it in the arcades, I like to try to play it. Frogger was, I don't remember playing it nearly as much as Kaboom, but I do remember that I just basically tried to get across the screen as fast as possible. I was really young, you know, I was about 5 or 6, so I didn't really grasp the concept of sometimes, you know, you have to move backwards to move forwards. So I got squished a lot.
The very, very classy wood grain isn't the only thing that as a kid got your attention with this system.
No,
I love this story.
I love the switches. For some reason, I guess I've always maybe deep down wanted to be like a pilot or something, but I would pretend that this was like a spaceship console and I would just move the switches back and forth. I probably screwed up so many settings I couldn't tell you, but I just loved it.
Red alert, red alert. Raise shields. Ready phasers and photon torpedoes. Give me a readout on that tactical response.
Pew, 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 pew. I will admit, even as a kid, I always thought the controller could have been a little better. That joystick, it was always very rough on the hands. And it inevitably always seemed to happen. For some reason, they would always have that one joystick that lost his little sleeve, and then he just had that white pokey stick there. And of course, if you were the littlest kid, that's the one you got stuck with.
Yeah. And honestly, I like the wood grain. I mean, I grew up in the 80s, so everything had wood grain. You know, your Atari had wood grain, your VHS player had the case things had wood grain, your cassette tape thingies had wood grain, your cars had wood grain.
We should push to bring back wood grain in our consoles.
I still really like the way the machine looks.
Yeah, it's got an almost timeless quality to it. The grooves in the black plastic, it streamlines the system.
I love anything sci-fi. I love the atomic age of the 50s and the 60s. So this looks sci-fi. I mean, I feel like I would see this in like a Star Trek episode in the quarter.
Oh yeah, back late 70s, early 80s, this definitely felt like this is the future of computer systems. Mm-hmm. And I love that you have just the small emblem, Atari, right here in the corner. They could have put it across the whole front of this, but they did not. They could have put it up here on the top where it says video computer system, but they chose to put it right there and just, it's like an accent to it.
I love the clean, straight lines that it's got on it. It's just, it's what they call a sexy machine.
Those old reruns keep your family apart. Does your dog fall asleep at the very start? Then turn off the TV.
And here's what you will see when you play a game from Atari. Have you played Atari today?
With an Atari game, a flick of the switch turns your TV set into a playground and your family room into a family room.
Have you played Atari today?
All right, well, a lot of memories to be had with the Atari 2600. The games, the system itself, the, you know, what's going on in your life, the culture, the wood grain culture going on in life. So please, nerdlings, drop some comments down below about your first gaming console, your memories there, or better yet, if you happen to do a response video, feel free to bring that link over, drop it in the comments so everyone can check it out. And while you're at it, give the video a like, you know, because you like the Atari. Why not? Ring a bell for the Atari. It's as easy as flipping a switch.
Listen to that noise.
Same with...
so satisfying.
Same with subscribing. All you have to do is... Right there. Look at that. I'm subbed. Hit the notification bell. Comment. And as always, please...
Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Go over to TeePublic because we have merchandise over there. Hit us up on the Retro Refresh. they have merchandise on TeePublic as well. And if we like it, nerdlings,
we nerd it for some good old 8-bit blocky action.
Yeah, so hey guys, let's nerd all about it for your memories.
Bye guys.
Bye.
Only Atari makes the world's most popular home video games. The only Space Invaders. The only Asteroids. The only Pac-Man. The only Missile Command. And soon, the only Defender. And the only way you can play any of them is on a home video system made by Atari.